railroads have had a fascination for many people since the first steam-powered railroad ran in England in 1813. The first steam locomotive in America, a British engine named the Star Bridge Line, made one run of 16 miles in Pennsylvania in 1829. Models of trains have existed for as long as the full-size ones. Many new designs were first tried out on models, and models were also used for patent applications. Model railroads in our present time have come to be used mostly for recreation. The hobby of working with models requires a lot of intelligence and skill, but the result is a lot of personal satisfaction. Model electric trains, such as shown in this fairly elaborate home layout, are very popular with hobbyists. This is an HO layout, but there are a number of other scale sizes to fit the space available. Sizes of model trains vary from tiny electric units, which can be held in the palm of the hand, to the amusement park types, which can carry 20 persons in a car. In between these extremes, there is a size range of from 1/2 inch to 1.5 inches per foot scale, which may be ridden on, but is still small enough to be easily transported by automobile. These are the live steamers, the little giants to which this picture is dedicated. The track layouts for these trains takes a lot more space than is normally available around home, so much of the model operation is done at club tracks in city parks or in large estates. City of Los Angeles is located a club track for the Los Angeles Live Steamers. If we go out there now, we might see one of the little giants. Although many kit parts are available, quite a few live steamers prefer to machine their own from raw stock or from castings, many of which are made from their own patterns. A steam locomotive is a very complex piece of mechanism which contains many functional systems. Buzz Such, the builder of this Atlantic, spends a lot of time oiling parts, checking for loose bolts and packing glands, worn parts, and cleaning dirt and grit from moving parts. This maintenance work is a constant demand on the owner's time, but successful operation on the track brings a lot of satisfaction. Occupations of Los Angeles Live Steamers Club members include doctor, lawyer, machinist, mechanical engineer, artist, television staffer, aerospace engineers, businessmen, electrical engineer, toolmaker, and computer programmers, to name a few. Although these hobbyists have varied occupations, they all have a common interest when they meet at the club facility in Griffith Park. Members associate with people they would normally never meet in their workplaces, and many strong friendships develop. Typical sunny day at the park, Buzz Such brings in his 08-0 for operation and to enjoy the results of his locomotive construction and maintenance. Mr. Such is assisted in all of the preliminary work by Chuck McNeil. Thank you. Tuff was once a race car driver. Now he races his 1-inch Fireball Atlantic on the rails at LALS.
Thank you.
Wheel assemblies, or trucks, are very critical parts of the riding cars. The trucks must be well designed and built to very tight tolerances in order to avoid derailments over rough track. The axles must run in low friction bearings to ease the drag load on the locomotive on long trains. Wheels are usually iron castings. Bolsters and side frames are usually made of cast bronze or aluminum alloy. Very careful machining is required on a wheel to make it run true. These parts are machined by Dick Royal, a professional machinist. Here are the parts for a freight car truck assembly. The wheels on their axles, the bolster, the two side plates, and with the 8 compression springs in their seats. Putting the springs in is a very tricky bit of business and takes very agile fingers. Flexibility is of prime importance. The finished truck is tested at the club track on a slight downgrade, and it must roll free. The BLS meet is next weekend, and the club members are very busy getting ready for the big event. This 1.5-inch scale locomotive was donated to the club by the park department so that there would always be an engine at the track. Really enjoys his homemade speeder. Trouble is, he almost got killed on the thing one time. Dumped him off on a fast curve. This is Saturday morning, the first day of the BLS meet, and the weather is ideal. This is Mark Piper's beautiful American locomotive and train. From Massachusetts, New York, Missouri, Arkansas, Oregon, Washington, Canada, Hawaii, Colorado, Nevada, and England were all present. At the meet, there were 16 inch-and-a-half scale engines, 25 one-inch scale engines, and 6 three-quarter inch scale locomotives. There was a total of 839 registered engineers and spectators. This three-truck shay built by Gordon Corwin is beautifully detailed in every respect. It has a set of trucks for 7.5-inch gauge track and another set for 4 3/4-inch gauge track. This Heiser engine, like the Shay, is gear-driven, but features a V2 engine which straddles the bottom. This 3/4-inch scale Invicta, built by Oscar Huter, is the smallest engine at the meet. The combined weight of the engine and tender is 21 pounds. The steam pressure gauge is only 1/4 inch in diameter. Thank you.
16A, double heading with a Finger K4. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.